Hi friends, good morning. Welcome back to SGK English, Elementary English Grammar and Spoken English. Last 3 days, we studied forms of be, then forms of do and forms of have. These three are primary auxiliaries. Auxiliaries are of two types, primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Just recollect what we had learned, you see, last few days. Okay, remember, first of all, what is an auxiliary? See, auxiliary verbs. Just remember, what is an auxiliary? Can you tell me? What is meant by an auxiliary? Auxiliary simply means helping verbs. Auxiliaries are so called because they are used with regular verbs. They are used with regular verbs. To help, underline that, study that. To help in the formation of tense, formation of voice, mood, or to make the meaning clear. Auxiliary means helping verbs. Auxiliaries are so called because they are used with regular verbs to help. In order to help, maybe in the formation of tense, voice, mood, or to make the meaning clear. That is what auxiliary verb is. And auxiliaries are of two types. Primary auxiliaries. They are three. What are they? Forms of the verb be, am, is, are, was, were. We saw already. Then do, do, does, did. And have, that we saw yesterday. Have, has a singular, had, past. And had, past participle. Have, had, had, has a singular. Okay now? Be, do, have. They are primary auxiliaries. What is the difference between primary auxiliary and modal auxiliaries that we are coming to? Primary auxiliaries can be used as finite as well as auxiliary verb. Finite means regular verb having V1, V2, V3. They can be used as finite as well as auxiliary verb. Okay, now? Yes. So, did you do your homework? First, did is auxiliary. Do is finite. You see? Have you had your dinner? You saw yesterday. We saw yesterday. Isn't it so? Yes. So, they can be used as finite as well as auxiliaries. That is why they are known as primary auxiliaries. Now, we are coming to the most important part of our auxiliary, topic, that is modal auxiliaries. See, modal auxiliaries. Look here, modal auxiliaries. What are the main or chief modal auxiliaries? Shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, need, dare, used to. Many are there. All we cannot study immediately. So, we will learn slowly. See, when there is time. We will complete some more. Then, we will go for next topic. Then, we will come back when there is time. Okay, now. So, modal auxiliaries. What is meant by a modal auxiliary? So, modal auxiliaries or modals express the mode. See, or manner. Of the verbs that follow them. They express the mode or manner of the verbs that follow them. Take for example, you can go now. What is the meaning of that? You can, you are permitted to. You cannot go now. No, you are not permitted to. No, you will, future. You shall, you must. You may, possibility. You need to go. You need not go also. You need to go. You need not go. You must go now. See, this is a mode or manner. These auxiliaries express the mode or manner of the verbs that follow them. In what way should you go? Is it you shall go, you must go, you need not go, you may go, you may not go? So they express the mode or manner of the verbs that follow them. They express ideas like possibility, permission, polite request, etc. Would you, could you, could you kindly come with me? Would you lend me, use your textbook? Is it not so? So would, could, may, might, all these things are there. See, polite request. See, they express ideas like possibility, may I, you see, you may, permission, you can you. Yes, polite request, could you, would you. So they express ideas like possibility, permission, polite request, etc. So modal auxiliaries or modals express, I mean, the mode, see, the mode or manner of the verbs that follow them. This is a verb that is following, is it not so? See, when you go to a classroom or to an office, you will first, you will ask, what will you ask? Can I come in, please? Can I? If you are somewhat familiarly, you say like that. Could you allow me? Or please may I come in, sir? Request. Please may I come in? May I come in, please? You can ask such, that way also. You know, so. So request politely, you have to ask. You see, so better say please first. Please, then they will, lift their head and ask, may I come in? May I come in? Isn't it so? Please may I come in, sir? You can ask a polite request. Or asking something, could you lend me your pen? Isn't it so? If, do you mind me giving your pen? Yes, would you kindly come with me? Would you? Could you? So, that is a would, could, might, etc. is more polite than, can, you see, will, etc. Isn't it so? So, majorly for, a possibility. He may come. It may rain. Whereas it might rain means remote possibility. May is possibility. Might means remote means far away. Little possibility only will be remaining. That is might. So, may, might. Should is now very often used. See, shall, should, other than that, what is expected to be? Student should bring the hall tickets. Should. What is expected to be? All should be present here by 9 a.m. Means must. This is what is expected to be. You see, you must register. You should register your name if you want to get admission. Register. Isn't it? So, registration process. You should. So all these auxiliary models, they are all necessary in your day-to-day life. Each one has a purpose to perform. So you have learned some of them. Then only you can speak fluently as well as write good English. Not butler English. Okay, now? Good English, you have to write, talk, and be able to express nicely. So for that, you must know the use of primary auxiliaries as well as modal auxiliaries. So, auxiliary means helping verb. Two types are there, primary and modal. Primary can be used as finite as well as auxiliary verb. Is it not so? And modal auxiliaries or modals describe or narrate the mode or manner. I repeat, the mode or manner of the verbs that follow them. See, they express ideas like, listen, possibility, you may. Permission, you can. Polite request, could you, etc. and etc. See, you may. See, you might. You can. Permission. Polite request, could you, would you. Okay, na? Yes. So, they express ideas like possibility, permission, polite request, etc. Is it clear to you? We saw what is meant by auxiliary. Auxiliary means what? Helping verb. Used with regular verbs. Auxiliary verbs are used with regular verbs to help in the formation of tense. We saw tense, you see, present continuous tense, amis are being used, no? Present perfect, has, have being used, tense, voice, V3, B plus V3 is passive form. So, etc. Many use are there. Okay, now? Yes. So, they are used with verbs to help in the formation of tense, voice, mood, etc. or to make the meaning clear. Auxiliaries are of two types, primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Modal auxiliaries or modals describe the mode or manner or the verbs that follow them. They express ideas like possibility, permission, polite, request, etc. Especially take care of polite request. Wherever you go, you have to ask permission now. Could you? Can you? Would you? Okay now. Yes, can I come in please? Is it not so? May I come in, sir? You can ask. You have to ask, you know. And you are giving permission. You can come in. You may kindly come in please. Okay now. Yes, you have to give permission sometimes. Can I take your book? Yes, you can. Could you give me or lend me your book? Yes, of course. Isn't it so? So, asking, answering. Isn't it so? Asking, answering. For all that, you need this auxiliary verbs. Primary auxiliaries as well as modal auxiliaries. I hope it is clear to you. See, for more updates, subscribe to the channel SGK English. Thank you.